Welcome to my channel, So Simple. Today we're going to learn how to make a pair of shorts with a zipper. So I'm using non-stretch fabric for this project. Take a piece of fabric, cut it in half like this, so you have two pieces. Then what you're going to do with that piece is you're going to fold it in half this way. So when you count how many layers you have, you should have four layers. Okay, now what you do is you take a pair of shorts that are not stretch. This is a regular fabric. Turn them inside out. Take the longest side. Fold it with that side out like this. So this is the short side, the crotch area, and this is the longest side in the back. You're going to fold it this way, like this. You're going to line it up to your fabric. Now, depending on where you place the shorts, for instance, if this here, this area here, of course, will determine how long they're going to be. Okay, so I have mine on this fold, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut. You could trace, you could pin. The point is you're going to cut around the short. Make sure you leave enough seam allowance. You're going to cut around, and when you get to this piece, you're going to go straight up. So do that, and I will be right back. Okay, when you have your pieces open, you're going to take your pair of scissors, and you're going to cut like half an inch on this curve all the way up to the end, and that will be the back side of your pants. Okay, so you mark like half an inch and just cut all the way up on one side of your piece only. The other side is the short end, you leave it alone, and this is going to be your long end, your back side. Now, in an effort to make the addition of the zipper a bit easier, what I did was I took a pair of scissors and I cut straight up in the center of my piece of fabric. Okay, so I just cut straight up to separate it. So now you have two pieces of fabric each. You have the short side on this end and you have the long side on this end. And to add the zipper, we're going to put the long side aside. And you're going to work with your shorter curve side, which is the front. So we're going to be adding the zipper to the front of your shorts. Now to add the zipper, you open up your pieces like that. You mark where you want your zipper to end. And then once you do that, you take your zipper, you put this part right here where the zipper ends, is where it's going to be, right there where you have marked it. And then you're going to make sure that these two fabric pieces meet up like this, because what you want to do is you're going to lay your zipper on top of it like this. And you're going to put a mark on how much fabric you're going to need for your zipper. So I'm going to use a piece of chalk. And I'm just going to mark there and there. This is to make sure that when I fold the fabric together, I have enough space for to fit my zipper. Okay, what you're going to do is now you're going to mark with a pen where the zipper ends, and where it ends is where this part cannot go any further. So on mine is going to end right here, so I'm just going to put a little mark there. Now you're going to fold your fabric this way. You're going to fold your fabric just to make it easier to work with. And what we're going to do now, I'm going to go to the machine just to show you, because you're going to sew from this end to this end in a regular stitch. You're going to backstitch here, sew, and backstitch there. And once you get here, now you're going to put your machine at the biggest stitch possible, because we're going to be doing a basting stitch. So from here to here is a regular stitch, and from here all the way here is a basting stitch, which is a really big stitch. And for this section, you will not backstitch, because we will be removing this stitch at some point. So I'm going to go to the machine to show you how to do that. I just want to show you real quick what your stitching should look like so far. Remember here, this is a stitch that will be permanent, that you'll be keeping. Here's my mark, my first mark. And then here's the part with the teeth of the zipper are gonna go. And unfortunately, I don't know if you can see the thread, but the stitches are bigger. And there's no back stitch in here, so that when I remove these, I won't have any problem. So that's what you have so far. What you're going to do now is you're going to open up the piece that you've just sewn. And you're going to take right here where you sewed, you're going to open that seam up like this. It's going to be this way. You're going to open it up, and you're going to take an iron, and you're going to iron that open. Make sure that you're ironing nice and neat, open all the way to the top, because this is where you'll be placing your zipper. So go ahead and do that, and I'll show you the next step. Now that you've ironed your seam flat, opened up like this, you're going to check, flip it over this way, so that you can see where your basting stitch starts. Okay, so this is your regular stitch right here, and right here is where I see that my bigger stitch starts. So I'm going to line up my zipper with the bottom part of it, the good side of the zipper. This is the back, this is the front, with the front side facing down. That's the part that you're going to see when you actually finish your project. And you're going to line it up where the big stitches begin, your basic stitch. Okay, so I'm gonna line it up right here like this. Now you want to make sure that the teeth of your zipper are lined up with that center seam. So right there in that center that you've ironed flat, You're gonna line up your zipper like that, because you want to make sure that when your zipper opens, your teeth are gonna be right in that seam in the center. Once you have it lined up like that, you're going to take some painter's tape, which is a kind of tape that's not very sticky. This is going to make this project so much easier than using pens and stuff. You're going to take some of this tape. This is painter's tape. It doesn't have to be this wide. And you're going to actually tape your zipper in place as such. You're going to tape it there. If it's not the wide one, it's okay. And you could also take your pieces of this tape, and you could just rip it in half. This is very easy tape to rip apart. So you've lined up your zipper, and you've taped it in place so that when you go to your machine, it doesn't move on you. I'm going to actually cut this one a little bit. Okay, we're keeping the zipper closed up to this point. So this is how it should look. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go to our machine and we're going to change our presser foot from a regular presser foot to a zipper foot. So if you have that, great. If you don't, it's okay. You can still do this without it. Hopefully you'll be able to hear me well. My camera is really not that great, so I'm doing the best that I can. You take your fabric that has not the zipper taped to it, and you're going to start with this section right here where the zipper pull is. Okay, you're going to put that piece of fabric in your machine this way. What you're going to do now is you're going to line up where your presser foot is, where your needle is going to be going. You want to make sure that you're not going to be hitting the teeth. So feel with your fingers where the teeth are, because that's not where you want your needle to go. It'll end up breaking your needle. Okay, so I've lined that up. I'm going to put my needle down. I'm going to lower my presser foot and I'm going to start sewing. So when you get to the bottom of where the end of your zipper is, you're going to leave the needle inside your machine. You're going to raise your presser foot and you're going to turn your fabric around like this, because what you're going to make is like a box around your zipper. So you're going to sew this way. When you get to the end here, you're going to do the same step again and you're going to sew to the top and leave the top open. When you get to the point where you started right here, you're not going to go all the way to the end because you have the little pull from your zipper in that section, and so it'll be hard for your presser foot to go through it. So you're going to stop right about here. Before you get to that part, give it a little back stitch and pull it out. So now that you've sewn your zipper in place, what you're going to do, you're going to turn your project around and you're going to remove all of the tape that you've added, which should be pretty easy. Once you remove all the tape, you're going to go on the other side where you did your basting stitch and you're going to take a seam ripper and you're going to open up the seams. So you remove the back, all the tape that you have on. And remember where you did the basting seam? You're going to take one of these little gadgets, it's a seam ripper, and you're going to carefully pop open those stitches where you did the basting stitch. Be very careful because these things could rip through your fabric. So do that all the way up and we'll continue in a minute. Okay, now what you do is you take your bottom part and you put it with the good side up, and you take your back part, your back piece, and you put it where the right side's meeting, like this. And then you're gonna line these up and you're going to now sew these pieces together on each side. The next step is you're going to pin the crotch area, the center area together. You're going to sew that together. Then you're going to go where your zipper is and you're going to fold. If you have excess fabric, you could cut that off from your shorts. If you don't, then what you do is you just fold it once up over the spot, this spot here where the zipper pull is. Okay, here's your zipper pull. You're going to take your fabric, you fold it over on this edge and on this edge because you want those two little tops to be covered. And then you're going to sew around until you come across to the side. Once you do that, do your hem and you are good to go. And there you have it. Your little shorts are completed. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.